Hi guys, this is Vidas, and today I'm going to show you how to master the chorale prelude Alle Menschen müssen sterben from Orgelbüchlein by Johann Sebastian Bach in 8 simple steps. It's a BWV 643 from the Orgelbüchlein collection. I'm using this Adagios for Organ collection edited by Roland Smith. You will find it in the description of this video, the link to it. Or if you want the fingering and pedaling provided for you, I have the score available also there. So the first thing we have to do is to actually look at the organ that we'll be using. I'm using Martinikirk in Groningen sample set by Sonus Paradisi. Let's choose the registration. So in the original edition there isn't indication that you have to play on two manuals, but in Roland Smith's collection he uses edition by Siegfried Kargelert, 19th century, beginning of the 20th century, style like Krieger a little bit. So the right hand plays the solo manual. Let's do this too. I won't be playing the pedals with heels like Kargelert implies, because in early music we don't do that, but you can change that if you want. So for pedals, let's do Prestan 16 and octave 8. For the manuals, for the right hand, how about Repositive Chalmers 8, Sesquialtera 2, Flaut 2, Gedacht Quint 3, Spielflaut 4, and Bourdon 8, like this. And for the left hand accompaniment, I could have Prince octave 8, for example. A little bit needs more juice, maybe octave 4 to octave 8. Okay, so the first step is actually to play the piece very slowly and stop it every beat. The tempo indication isn't given, but the meter is 4-2 in this edition, 4 half notes, so very very wide meter. So one half note is one beat, so I will be stopping at every half note here. I will mute the microphone and show you how it sounds. Thank you. Alright, this was the first step, stopping at every half note. Now let's stop at every whole note, second step. Alright, next step would be to stop at the beginning of every measure. Step number three. Step number four would be to stop at the beginning of every line in this edition, every two measures basically. Okay, step number five will be to stop at the beginning of every two lines or every four measures. Step number six would be to stop at the beginning of every page. And this is how it sounds. Okay, and now step number seven, I could play the entire piece without stopping. I think if this was the piece for two voices in the right hand part and not in the left hand part, I think seven steps would be enough. But I think I will repeat it one more time, step number eight, and to reinforce this learning process, because the left hand part has double intervals and very, very difficult to read sometimes, parallel six, and this is not very usual in early music, so you have to train your hand a little bit more. Okay, let's do it again. So I think the more you play this piece, the more steps you add, the more fluent you will become, obviously. But eight steps are generally enough for two pages of music, right? Not too many. And make sure to spend at least three correct repetitions in a row for each step before progressing to the next step. And therefore, if I did this piece, if I, let's say, fluently mastered this piece in 22 minutes, right, plus talking, so probably less than that, for you would be much more, even several days perhaps, if you are not used to practice for longer periods of time. Don't rush, take your time, this is a beautiful piece, worth spending your time on it, right? And if you want to master this piece and get to know it deeper, you probably need early fingering and pedaling written in. So I have the score available for you in the description of this video as well. Check it out. And good luck in your practice. This really is fun piece. Registration, solo registration works very well. If you want to play on solo, on single manual, that this is appropriate too. But then you have to use two hands in one stave. Right hand would take soprano and alto, and the tenor would be played by the left hand part. This is like this disposition is, I think, in Neue Bach-Ausgabe, but in the Bach-Gesellschaft-Ausgabe, BGA, this is like in Kargelerts, except in the left hand part there is alto clef written in, so you have to adjust. In the middle line, on the alto clef, there is C in the middle line, middle C, so if you're not afraid, you can use that score as well. This is the score that I'm using fingering and feathering written into. Okay, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. This was instructional, educational content for you. And if you want to get more videos from me, please subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. And click the notification bell so that you wouldn't miss any of my future postings. And I'll catch you online very soon. Thank you so much for joining in. Bye-bye.